got the time, I had to slide. You too high, remind me of the market in 05. They like to creep a lot, I like to trade the spy. And I know they don't believe in God, but feel him in my vibe. Okay, everybody, you know, you got the beautiful setup. I still need to make this setup. I hope you had a wonderful weekend, first of all, but this is all gonna provide context. It's a lovely day, I know. Weird flex, it's beautiful outside, but I promise this all has some level of context. You know, look at that, investment grade gold. Yeah, gold grill, investment grade gold. We'll talk about this, okay? But before I talk, I know you guys want a setup video or something like that, but I really need to talk about something important. This is going to be a very, very serious video, and I really, really want you to pay attention, okay? So make sure you subscribe. Hopefully you enjoy your weekend too, and yeah, let's get into it. All right, so I came down here to shoot it here. There's a lot of echo in there. I had some laundry and all that, and I really want you to get this, and you know, I got to flex the Tesla. This video is going to have a lot of weird flexing in it, and it's going to be to give some of the context. So this is, I'm telling you guys, I'm very, very serious on all this. You could even tell by the title, how to prepare for the next financial crisis without looking like a complete weirdo. And I want you guys to really understand this. There's a lot going on in the world. That's why I want to talk about this. I'm waiting for the weekend. I've been waiting. I am going to wait tomorrow. I'm going to have a cool video for you guys. So if you do want to learn about the markets and that's the next level, you know, this is kind of the base level. This is foundational. We're going to talk about the next level is capitalizing on a downturn or even just how to structure your investments throughout all of it. I have a video I'm dropping tomorrow. This is going to be for the option traders. We had a great lesson on one of the 11 at 11 calls. I'm going to go over literally how to find and predict 1,000% option gainers. No exaggeration. I even have an Excel model I'm going to show you guys. So hopefully you guys are there for that. I'll post that tomorrow. But I really do want to talk about this. There's honestly a lot going on. I wanted to break this up into separate videos, but I think I'll just put it all in here because, you know, there's a bunch of weird stuff going on. And I think that there is a lot of crazy stuff happening. And I think that a lot more crazier stuff is going to happen. And what makes me say that is there is a lot of events happening right now, even funny ones, stuff that seems funny or just overall weird, like Trump trying to buy Greenland, or even the introduction of 50-year, 100-year bonds. All of those historically, events like that, I don't think they're non-coincidental. You know, I talked about it on stream before. I said, you know, it's like it was like the introduction of the euro in 2001 or 2000 that eventually came in 2002. And that was a bigger central banking, you know, again, this could be a conspiracy theory, but this is my take on it. A ploy or whatever you want to call it to balance out the financial system and weaken the really, really strong dollar. You know, if Trump was going to buy Greenland, they would have to do that transaction in euros. And you know, that would actually weaken the dollar, which is good. That's what, you know, that's what people want, especially if the Chinese currency is weakening, that's strengthening the dollar. Hopefully you're seeing this. The next level is the 100-year bonds and 50-year bonds. The first time in 06 before 2008, when they did that, that was the first time they introduced the 30-year bond. And prior to that, it was extrapolated from the 10 and the 20. And that is what really flattened and killed the yield curve. And, you know, a year later, you saw what happened. So as far as the timing, I do not know. I think it could be 2019, 2020. Who knows? I made a video like this in the past saying, you know, my biggest advice, and this is the first thing, is save your money. And I really, really want you guys to do that. And I encourage you all to save your money. Again, both of those scenarios I'm talking about, everything, my big theory, if you haven't watched it, I'm not scared of inflation. I'm scared of deflation. I'm scared of the dollar getting too strong. And it's one of the biggest threats, I think, to the world. And again, with zero negative interest rates, the yield curve, all that, we are going through a paradigm shift. I think something's going to happen. And even I think both financial markets are going to have an effect, and even something, you know, again, earthquakes, shit like that. This is where I start to sound crazy. So I don't even care though, right? My job is to help you guys out. You know, I love you guys. And this is why I'm making this video, because I want it to come off in a way where I'm able to do this stuff. And it's literally how to prep for anything and everything without looking like a complete nut job. And guess what? People are going to call you a whack job, a nut job, no matter what, when it comes to this stuff, especially when you mention prepping and this and that. You know, am I a prepper? I don't know. I'd rather, you know, it's like the stream alerts. You know, it's better to have it and not need it than need it and not have it. I'm just a weird guy. You're talking to a guy who makes YouTube videos and doesn't show his face, and has thousands of friends online. I love you guys. You guys are my favorite, baby. Let's go, baby. But you can see, you know, that's why I pointed out some of this stuff. You know, it's not like I'm living off the grid in the middle of nowhere, you know, farming my own food. I literally have a penthouse. I'm in a Tesla, but you know, this is electric. It's not reliant on fuel. So that goes both ways, right? When it comes to extremes and stuff like that. But I'm not your typical, you know, doomsdayer in this. And I don't like that. I don't like fear porn. I'm not a big fan of that. You know, I'll go with whatever's going to make me money, whatever's going to honestly just keep me safe, my family safe, and the people I care about. You know, that's why I'm saying this. So that's why I got a few steps I want to go over. So let me get these organized for, you know, cover it. How to prepare for the next financial crisis or anything without looking like a complete nut job. So let's get into it. All right. So the first thing we need to discuss, this is two-pronged in the sense that this could mean many, many things, but and it also depends on the type of, you know, downturn or anything we have. And, you know, it's like, do we have an economic slowdown, a recession, and how to prepare for that, you know, from the investment standpoint. And then also in the sense of like a Mr. Robot event or something crazy like that. But the first thing and the very, very important thing is save your money. And now this may sound stupid, but this is what I'm saying. And this is the key to every single one of these steps with preparing for any sort of financial crisis. It is that preparation is doing nothing too crazy. So what I mean by that is that this is stuff that you should be doing anyways, or if you took these steps and the worst case didn't occur or something bad didn't happen, would you still be worse off or would you be disappointed? And the answer should be no. So for instance, if I told you start saving 10% of your money right now, every dollar you touch, like you should be doing, but now as we're entering a different era, a paradigm shift with rates and all other sort of stuff, maybe you could increase it to 15%. So let's say you do that for the next 12 months. Let's say you do it for the next 24 months and nothing happens, right? The market goes up, everything's fine, you know, there's no any problems anywhere. Are you going to be mad or would you look like a nut job telling people, hey, save 10% of your money, save 15% of your money? No, that wouldn't make, again, do you see, that's the first point. But now this is what I'm saying and why this is so important right here, right now, is some of you guys are not doing that. And some people really do not take that seriously or have a savings plan. Yeah, there's articles, oh, if the Americans did this, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I don't care. I'm not basing it off that. Just save your money and start right now. And again, I understand, you know, it's hard for me to understand it, sure, but you have to understand I've been in situations. I come from an immigrant family. I'm the youngest of many, many children. I didn't always have money. I grew up with cereal and water. That's what we didn't have, cereal and milk. We had the Walmart bag, big ass cereal, and we put water in it. It's easy to see where I'm at now. It's easy, again, all this, the weird flex stuff, whatever you want to call it, but I saw my parents lose everything through the financial crisis. And even before, we were poor, got rich, and then got even poorer after that. So it was a very, very different time. So I want to make sure you guys actually take this seriously and start. And if you think you can't save now, that is a lie. And what I mean by this is start every dollar you touch, put 10% of it away. Every dollar you touch, get 10 cents and hide it away from you. You will be able to survive. Oh, I got bills, I got this and that. Go pay yourself first and then pay your bills. You will find that you can actually still end up doing it. And that's the key to it. But please, please do that. And if you can do 15 or 20%, start doing that right now and save your money. Cash is king. My theory relates to deflation, the dollar going up in value. So if your dollar increases in purchasing power and something happens, your savings will be good. Now, the next part is to have physical cash. So this is the extreme part. Now, this is where it's saying, what if you can't access your money? Or, you know, again, a lot of us, again, I'm young and, you know, I'm born and raised on this technology. I'm very, very reliant on tech. But if you can't access your money, that will be a problem. It's always good to keep, you know, keep a little bit on you. I don't walk around with cash, have a safe, put it in a safe place, even with gold. Gold is something good to have, and I recommend it, you know, a lot. That's why I don't like paper gold. I don't like buying gold futures or anything like that. I only buy physical gold and physical silver, and I store it in places because it's good to have. That will be something, again, it's there to sustain value. That's why people buy it. That's why too, when the market's ripping, they call it a pet rock. It doesn't make sense when, you know, the market's increasing 8% every year for you to buy gold, but go look at the last 24 months where the market's up and down, up and down, up and down, only to stay in the same place. It makes sense why gold is doing what it's doing. It's a store of value, and in times when now there's less opportunity in equities, people go to gold, but it's something good to have too physically. That's why I always keep it, but cash. So, and I'm telling you this, is a lot of this stuff. I'll tell you another story with this, but this comes from, I went crazy before, and this is what even got me in my be prepared mindset. This was a long, long time ago. I remember I was getting a little, somebody brought it up to me, and I was getting, I don't know where the thought come from. I was getting a little paranoid. I don't know why, you know, but I remember I was walking out, and I walked by a homeless guy, and I was walking in at the time, I was driving the Maserati. And, you know, and think about it, Maserati, Italian Maserati, oh, yeah, flex, flex, flex. No, but the point that got me was that I was driving, or I was walking up to that car, and then when I was trying to, I unlocked it, and I realized at that moment, I only had my key for the Maserati and my wallet on me. I never kept cash, I never kept anything on me, and then I was just like, what separates me from this homeless guy? If my credit card in my pocket somehow stopped working, sure, I would have the Maserati. And like, honestly, you see how I dress, you know, I look like I'm homeless. You know, again, yeah, this might be fancy. I got this as a gift. So shout out. He won't let me shout out in LA. I had to, I love him. He said he's going to let me give him a shout out here soon. He said he wants to prepare it, but he said he made a lot of money on TLT. He gave me a gift. He knew I wouldn't buy certain things, so he hooked me up with this. But even then, some people would think this is fake. I'm wearing, you know, sweatpants, just a white t-shirt with the stain. You know, I wear holes with, sweaters with holes in it. People will tell me on YouTube, people will say shit. Like, I dress, like, again, people would think I stole this car, if anything. And if anything happened, they're like, you know, what would separate me from that guy monetarily, you know? And that's why I was like, maybe I should have cash or something of that nature. So always keep it on you physically. Or not on you, but have it. But there's that. Now to a more financial thing now, you need to take account. This is step two. Take account of everything you have now. Get a balance of everything you own. How much cash do you have? Assets, debt, what do you owe? And now there's a mix between knowing how much debt you have, and we can't talk about paying it off or not. And again, this is where it all matters, because you start by getting an account of what you have and figure out what you have. If you own stocks and investments, ask yourself, how much do you have? And then discount it. You know, if it did drop 30-40%, if you did panic, at what point would you want to panic sell? See what you have, see what you owe, and then see the carrying value too. So if you have debt on something, what is the value of it? So if, like, this car, if I owe $30,000 on it, how much can I sell it for tomorrow? Figure those amounts so you can kind of get an idea of where you're at with everything. And then now you have to ask yourself, if it did go down to zero, if it did this go down to discounted value, how would that affect you? Or is there certain things you would be willing to let go? Now, this is where it gets a little bit weird. I've said this too, you know, some properties, I'm not advocating this at all. This is totally reckless, financially irresponsible, but I'm speaking in the nature of, if you ever got into a financial position where your assets are dropping in value, or you have debt that you need to service and you can't afford it, the key you need to figure out, that's why by taking an account of what you have, you need to prioritize and literally prioritize all of your payments, and you have to have step 1, 2, 3, 4 of what you need to do. And the first step is always roof over your head. That's the house. But now even then, you could understand the process. Even if there is a foreclosure and they want to kick you out, even if you rent and they want to evict you, that could still buy you 3 months of time. And again, that's all, I'm speaking crazier. That's super, super extreme, but you have to prioritize. You need a house and you need to feed yourself. Everything else is pretty much extracurricular. So you have to decide and take an account of, okay, what if I did pass up on this, or if I did choose to pay this, or you have stuff that you could pay off now that you're really close to paying off, try to, but if there is a change in anything, you don't want to have a lot of debt, or you don't want to have that debt cripple you. And know what you can do and how fast it takes for debt to get off of your record. But again, my theory is, if the dollar does go up too much and the dollar does strengthen,
the worst thing to have is dollar-denominated debt, because if the value of the dollar goes up, $1 gets you a lot more things. People are going to start paying less for things because the dollar is so strong. But if you owe a lot of money, that stays fixed. You're going to owe a lot of money. You're going to be in debt by a lot of things. So keep that in mind and take account of what you have, because without doing that, you don't know what you're preparing with, preparing for, so on and so forth. But a lot of people miss this factor, and it's, again, the key is to know what you have so you can prioritize as you move forward. So again, taking this into context, are you really a whack job for preparing by knowing your assets and liabilities, by balancing your books and being prepared, by literally figuring out a book value on your life and being able to discount and get charge-offs and understand what you have in your life that is goodwill, hard assets, and everything else, and then having a plan if you did indeed have to default on any of your unsecured debt, or if you have debt that you know is unsecured that you could default on and all that you're going to risk is your own personal life, company's credit rating? I don't know. This is what companies do, so it's not crazy if you do it. But I don't know. That's just me. That's what I'm doing, okay? So don't take me for it, you know. But again, this is the next thing, you know. Those are the main two things so far. Hopefully you guys realize preparing doesn't mean you're crazy. Preparing doesn't mean anything outside of the norm. Like, oh my God, this is just being financially educated to a degree, and even honestly just to a whole nother level. There's financial education, and then this is just being prepared and you know, one step ahead. And this is why I always say, like I told you guys, we lost everything. That's when I first started getting into trading. I didn't even know how to short a stock, man. If I knew what I knew today, my family wouldn't have lost what they lost. And you know, without that, I wouldn't have got to see and learn, and I would not be who I am today and have this you know, paranoia and fear towards it. And yeah, I will say paranoia. Like, what do you think it keeps, you know, me going that time, man? If you're like that Big Sean, like, man's losing everything, boost my adrenaline. I think only some people could really relate to that if you've been in that situation or you know what it's like. Like, I'm a big fan of protection and what it means to money. I'm not, you know, I will make sure none of that ever happens for my family. If I could help some of you guys in the same way, you know I'll do it too. But again, this is the whole point, because the thing that I think where a lot of people mess up on is that if they do this, any of these steps, and then they are over preparing and they're missing out on opportunities or taking too much time, that's when it hurts. And now the next part, this is step three. This is where it gets a little crazy, but here's the thing. Three, don't push your ideas on anybody. You know, I'm hopefully you guys see this is stuff I want to say, but I'm finding the right time to put it out. I'm trying to frame it in the right way, but you don't need to put everybody on this, in the sense that people are going to make their own decisions. You don't need to stress it. And at the same time, if things did happen, just because you've prepared does not mean you have to help anybody, and be very, very careful with who you decide to help when it does get to that moment. And now you can help people with knowledge, you can help people with time, but be careful of any obligations you are going to make to secure other people's debt. That's one thing. But again, be cautious with how you tell people about any of this stuff, because it's very polarizing. That's why even I'm sure how many people are going to think I'm crazy after posting this or say this or that. I would just say, you put it out there, you give it there, you don't need to press the issue too much. The best thing you could do is always set an example, and you know, just be there and ready to go. But this is what leads to the next thing now, is always have an exit plan or a really ultimate safety backup. And this is part of taking the balance. But what I mean by this now is have cash. This is the one thing now I say, is focus on stuff with intrinsic value. Focus on what is necessary to live. And especially in modern cities and everything out, this is where it gets real prepper, but this is what I always do. So this is my logic again. Water and food and cash and gold and silver. I always get the gold and silver are like your total base backup plan. I do have my Bitcoin, but again, if no internet, hard technology, how are you going to get the Bitcoin? Hey, I got hard drive, 1 million Bitcoin. No, you know, but this is something. So this is what I did last time I went crazy with this. And again, people said I was crazy with it. And again, I think in the mistake I made was I kept telling people, I was like, yo, you should do this, watch out, like, get this, get that. And again, I'm saying this because you don't want to be the boy who cries wolf, because one, You'll get it held against you, and it will discourage you from ever being prepared and safe in the future. And you're going to feel like a kid who believed in Santa Claus and found out it was real, and then you're going to feel like a schmuck forever believing it. But then also, if anything happens, you don't want everybody to know you're the plug. You know what I'm saying? That's why you're the plug. They shouldn't know. You know, if you know, you know. You know what I'm saying? But again, this goes back. It's not crazy. Keep stuff that makes sense. Like, look, there's a hurricane going on right now. People are ran out of water in Florida. People in food. If there's anything with infrastructure, if there's an earthquake and you don't have water, what are you gonna do? You know, that's the thing. People, if you don't need food, I don't eat any of the mornings. You guys see that on stream. You can't go, I think, what, 72 hours, 48 hours without clean water? Or if you ingest dirty water, you're done, dude. Water is very, it's intrinsic value. I'm invested in water stock long-term as well. You see, I'm in it on paper, but I also invest, that's something I invest in. See, it pays a dividend. Gold GLD does not pay a dividend, my friends, you see? But that's why I hold those stocks, but then I also have actual physical water. I have tons of water. But again, now for someone like me, I drink water bottles all the time. It's not crazy. So that's why people had made fun of me when I used to buy all these. They're like, why are you buying so much? I'm like, well, if anything happened, that's one reason, but I'm gonna drink it anyways. Like, everybody needs water. Ah, my car, everything shut off here. But, and again, you know, and this is part of it. This is, you know, Tesla's electric. Again, having gas, you guys could get generators too. I would say solar, that's like really extreme. I have one little mini solar generator. But I also have exit plans. You know, if anything happened, you know, for me, I'm more prepared for an earthquake. Again, it's just saying, it's one, if you can't access money or access the same things, or even store payment processing went down, how would you acquire stuff? But also, again, that's Mr. Robot shit. But really, you know, I think what's more really realistic and applicable, and just saying, you know, it's better be safe than sorry, natural disasters. And we're seeing a lot of crazy shit recently. Make sure you have that. But again, water is fine. Like, you know, some people will say canned food. Guess what? Tuna, one of the best canned food. Tuna, crackers, almonds, nuts, those protein shakes. Oh my God. Like, look, this is the fucked up part about all of it. You're going to drink this and eat this stuff regardless. At least I would. You know, tuna's good. You guys want to get swole? Get some tuna. Guess what? If anything happens, you got backup tuna. You got backup protein. You see? I don't know. So I don't know though. That's my take on it. I could go on this forever, but I think I've already ranted enough on this whole topic. So hopefully this helps you guys. Hopefully you like it. Let me know what you guys think. If you have any other tips or advice, let me know. But is this very accurate? Tell me, you know, is any of this stuff, does this make you crazy for preparing in this way? And as you guys see, I'm not telling you to be a hardcore prepper, you know, turn your necklace into a fucking rope and shit like that. But I want you guys to be smart. But if you don't listen to anything here, please save your money. That's all I'm saying. Save it. Get a little purchasing power. You never know, the value of something today may not be the same in the future. What your dollar gets you today is only based on what is accessible with economics and how trade works. So if any disruption in trade lines or anything changes, your value is going to change in what you have. So really think about that and get ready for the econ course. I'm gonna get you guys information on that. But again, save your money. If that's not something you could afford, I'd rather have you save money than pay for an econ course. And hope, and again, I'd rather have you save money than go after a YOLO demon. So just please be smart with your money, get some good timing, and at the end of the day, be chill, man. God is good. You know, you guys know what I believe, and that's another mistake I've made in the past, is panicking. Don't ever panic. Ever, ever, ever. You guys got the cult. You guys know I'm here. If anything ever, you know, if, what is it, SHTF, you know, if it ever hits the fan, you guys know I got you. It's simple as that. And it's never, and everything did ever hit the fan and go crazy, it always happens in stages. So even if it's like, what if I can't get you on the internet? Oh my God! Yo, I need to talk to a manager. I can't get a hold of my YouTube on Josh. Don't worry, there'll be some period. I'll find a way. I'm pretty clever. We'll get it going. You know, I got you guys. So don't panic, man. Chill. And you know, if you're scared, go to church, get a pit bull, do whatever you need to do, but you got to chill out. God is good. Keep it all easy. I've told you, I messed up in the past by panicking before. No one ever made good decisions panicking. So if you're prepared, you have no need to panic, and that's it. So that's why, get your balances, prepare everything, be smart, but save that money, baby. All right, I love you guys. Get ready for the video tomorrow and enjoy your weekend. Peace.